I grew up my entire life living with my biological father and my two brothers. My older sister left the house at a very young age, and we didn't understand why, but I do now. So my sister was the first victim, and my sister was the one to disclose to me when I was 20. And that is when my story really begins for myself. I didn't disclose until I was 20, and my sister and I spent a very long time crying, sharing, listening, putting pieces together, trying to put together a puzzle that no child should ever have to be given. I confronted basically my entire family. My sister took my hand and we went straight to my house. And we opened up the door, and out from the room came my mother and Tony. And all I said to him was, "I just want you to admit it." And at the time, my mother was very confused. Tony comes out and admits to both sexually assaulting myself and Leanne. And my mom lost it. She started hitting Tony and crying and screaming. But after that night, everything went back to normal. My mom and Tony were still sleeping in the same bed in which he had abused me on. Finally started to take care of myself and put an end to those things that I didn't want in my life anymore. And that started with a very long letter to Tony in the mail telling him to leave me alone, essentially. And that I didn't want any more contact from him, I didn't want to hear from him, that I wanted to start healing and growing and living a life without this. Clearly realized that very soon that was not going to be the case. All of the classes, every class was talking about sexual abuse, every class. I was going to class and being triggered every day, and I was going to class and unfolding basically my entire trauma without having any support or and have done any level of healing. Durham is where I essentially fell apart and put back together the pieces. So I began a very long journey, and so it seems that it's very weird to look back on it now, the amount of therapy I have done, but since I have been 22, I have done multitudes of therapy. None of it has done the work that is needed for somebody to heal. I suffer with PTSD and depression. I suffer with generalized anxiety. I have a eating disorder, which is anorexia, and I live with self-harm. Which is still a everyday battle, struggle, nightmare. I don't think I've ever felt more alone than in the last 2 years. I definitely have struggled a huge amount with suicide ideation and suicidal thoughts. That's probably one of the worst things to battle, would be that at 25, like, I'm okay with it being over. I know that many people have been able to start their own journey of healing and recovery after having a conversation with me, not because of me, but because we are now living in a world where we're validating each other's experiences, and we are validating the fact that it's okay to get help and it's okay to tackle your demons. I think it's really important that we share our pain as much as we share our joy. This is Riley. And I got Riley specifically for my mental health. Riley and I met, and it was love at first sight. And Riley has been actually huge for me in my mental health. Riley has helped me understand eating again, He doesn't cure eating disorders, but I had to learn that I had to feed him and that I needed to feed myself. Oh boy. And, he's probably one of the reasons, if not, like, the reason that I still wake up every day and I'm still here every day. It's because he gives you life. Animals put life back in your soul. So another incredible tool that I have discovered is traveling. For me, traveling is one of the most freeing and beautiful experiences. That's been something that I will continue to do, is traveling on my own and continuing to take myself and put myself into situations that are unknown, that are new, that are different, that are going to bring me some sense of wonder for sure. I have had so many incredible experiences. I have skydived over the Pacific Ocean. I have watched whales and dolphins swimming in the ocean over a sunset. I have seen some of the most beautiful Zen gardens around the world. I have seen some of the most incredible castles, and all through this is me validating that my life is worth it, and that I'm worth it.